Bitcoin continues to have some difficulties in breaking the $48,000 to $51,000 line of resistance. We have been having a small retracement since yesterday, but the big outlook for Bitcoin continues to be bullish. This and much more coming your way. Stay tuned. The podcast is about to begin. Hello guys, welcome to another FU Money. Today is Monday, the start of the week, and of course we will see how the previous week closed and how this week is already looking. But Bitcoin has been retracing since yesterday, as I said in the intro. However, the big outlook for Bitcoin, the big charts with the monthly and weekly candles still look bullish, and there's also a squeeze in the price action starting today. So let's go to the charts and start analyzing what's going on. So here is the total market cap for the cryptocurrencies. And as you guys can see, I have my Fibonacci Uber Special Elite plotting here with the two color bars. And as you guys know, this is calculated from the all-time high of the crypto total, which was almost 2.6 trillion. And the bottom part here at around $1.12 trillion. So what I wanted to emphasize here in this chart is the fact that since we started to go up, since the price reversal here, around the 21st of July, that the trend channel has been going up and the bulls are completely in control of the situation, as you guys can see here by the green dots at the bottom. So right now we continue to have a lot of strength going up at the total crypto market cap, but there's a sign of possible price reversal action here. So there's a possibility that we will not have an easy path to continue to go up, surpassing this signal here on the indicator. But in any case, I continue to believe that the bulls are really in control right now, as you guys can see here. And the possible action right now is to have a range going on, and possibly later we will continue to the upside. I don't see this going back down to the previous levels where we had the reversal of the price action here. So the continuation is the most probable action right now. But let's see what's happening with Bitcoin, and we will go to the weekly chart. Today is just a quick update, as you guys know, recorded videos from Monday to Friday. Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, I usually have the shorter update on the price action. So here we start with the Bitcoin chart, the weekly Bitcoin chart. And as you guys know, if you have been following the previous videos, I was mentioning that it was really, really important that this candle here that I'm signaling, let's zoom in a bit. So this smaller red candle here that went to the top, it was very, very important that it did not close as a big red candle below the opening of the green candle here, so that this candle would not be an engulfing candle. And now this is closed, and it was closed just a few hours ago at 1 a.m. Portuguese time of Monday today. And now we are starting the next weekly candle. The next weekly candle has been retracing since the evening, so basically it started to retrace around the same time as the red candle closed, and we have been going a bit down since that time. But right now the outlook for the weekly chart looks very good, because this candle was not an engulfing candle, and I said already several times that even if we have a structure similar to the one here in January, of course these are bigger candles, but if the structure is the same, so this first red candle did not engulf the last green candle here, and the second went even lower in price. However, it was the candle that triggered the price action reversal to the upside. So it's possible that we can have the same kind of structure here. It's, in my opinion, the biggest probability is that we can still see a bit of retracement on the second candle, the current week's candle, and that might trigger then later the price action reversal to the upside, starting to have another green candle after this one. However, the base for this retraction, I believe it would be around the $42,000, which is the white line you guys see here on this chart. I'm not expecting a bigger retracement than this, around 42,000, being this a very, very good support since the early days of this year in January. This has been a very, very good area for support in Bitcoin's price action. So right now, we are on a green 7 count of 9, and it's still possible that we can have an 8th candle and a 9th candle on the green with at least a bit more continuation to the upside before a possible bigger retracement can occur. So right now, what I see is that for the short term, it's possible that we can see a bit of retracement more, and the levels that I've discussed already in this chart here are the $46,000, 46 to 46 and a half, which was already support once here, and the second level, the $44,000, which was one of the most important also lines of support and resistance in the past. But the big one, the big support that I believe will stop the retracement if this continues to the downside, will be the green area here. The $42,000 to the $38,000 area is one of the most important lines of support, and this is the one I don't believe that we will break to the downside, at least at this moment or in the next few weeks or months. So I believe that probably until the end of the year, we will still continue above this green area. Possibly the biggest probability is to have ranging here for some more time. And of course, these intermediate levels of support will be touched, and they also provide good opportunities to buy the dip in case that we retract and reverse the price action to the upside. However, let's go back to the previous chart, the weekly chart here, and let's continue the analysis on the MRI strategy indicator. So basically, the weekly chart has this outlook, as I described before. The price structure to me seems that it could be constructing a structure just like the one we had in January. 2 weeks of retracement and then reversal of the price action. Now, the only difference here is that I already have the levels on the other chart you guys seen, the levels where this retracement could go to. And those are good opportunities to buy the dip, in my opinion. And I've been doing that already at 46. I will do it at 44 and again at 42 if this continues the retracement. The RSI is just going sideways right now because of this retracement, so it's a bit neutral. But the trend line that comes from a long time ago has been supporting the RSI always in every occasion it touches. So I will trust this trend line, and you will see it on the daily chart just next. The MACD here is continuing on the bull side. So the blue line continues above the orange. We have already the third green bar, and I'm expecting that even if this bar becomes a bit lighter green, this will not even go to the downside, just like the ones you have here, the red ones and the light red ones. I'm expecting the MACD to continue pointing up or going sideways for just a bit while this retracement goes on. But in any case, that's what I'm expecting for now. So let's go to the daily chart. And the daily chart, you guys see, I have here this trend line also, which we broke around this candle on the 27th of August. And since then, we have been retracing a bit, but the trend line itself has been holding the price action. And here, there's also two more supports in conjunction with the trend line. We have the 200 period SMA, the purple line, and we have the green line, which is a 20 period SMA, and I will just zoom in a bit so you guys can see it better. So the 20 period SMA has been supporting the price in this retracement, and just after that one, we still have another one, which is a 200, the purple line. And guys, look here that the 50 period SMA, the yellow line, is coming back up in a fury since the last time we were really, really down there. So a lot of moving averages are converging to the same position, and even the 100 period, which is the red one, is already turning back up after the big, big retracement of 56% we had in May. So right now, for the first time, you can see that the 100 period SMA on the daily chart is going up. So that's also a good sign. Another thing that is the trend line on the RSI that I mentioned before on the other chart. You guys see here the trend line coming up, and every time the RSI touched this line, it went back up again. So in any case, the retracement that I am expecting for now is just at a maximum of touching this trend line here and then reversing back to the upside. That could take us to 46 or the 44 level of support, or even the 42, which is the white line here on the chart. And this was the one of the biggest swing highs we had just a while back. And it will also be, of course, you've seen it in the last chart of this video. You've seen it. This has been a very important line of support since January. So this is the most I'm expecting for a retracement. However, there are two intermediate levels that you've seen already that will be good opportunities in case of a price action reversal to the upside. The MACD on the daily chart, however, looks a bit bearish. And this is for the short term, of course, because in the bigger schema of things, in the weekly chart, we are still bullish. And I believe that the bulls are still in control of the price action. So on the daily chart, of course, we have the blue line below the orange. But I believe that this is just for this retracement, and we might be ranging a bit here around these levels before breaking up again. So let's see the 4-hour chart for a quick BitMEX funding rate analysis. So for now, we are almost neutral. We have 0.008 of here on the chart, on the levels of leverage and longs and shorts in BitMEX. The longs are, of course, in the positive side here. The premium is negative, but this is a bit neutral. There's nothing to see here because the numbers are very, very low. So this is almost neutral, not impacting any bulls or bears sentiment. However, there's one good sign here on the 4-hour chart for the RSI. You guys see here that the trend line you have been seeing from the weekly chart daily and now on the 4 hours is almost about to be touched. So this indicates, of course, that this retracement is possibly ending very, very soon, and we could start to see a reversal of the price action again. If that happens, we will have a higher low as compared to this area of the chart, and that's also a very, very good sign. So that's the 4-hour charts. Let's take a look at the Pro Indicators chart, and this is the 4-hour chart on the Pro Indicators in the strategy. And of course, I can give you a few levels of really important areas of the chart. So right now, you guys can see here that the trend channel was going up. Then we had this retracement indicated by the red triangle. Again, we had another retracement, which is the one we are having now, indicated by the red triangle. And we are very, very close to get to the bottom of the trend channel, which is the green zigzag line you guys see here. So right now, this is, for the really short term, this is the lowest level I'm expecting for this retracement, which will go around 46,500, exactly as the MRI indicator strategy also indicated. So where I told you that this would be, and you guys will see it also on the last chart. And this is for the short term, of course, because we still have the 42 line here, and you guys see the moving average is exactly going around the 42,000 line now. Just let me zoom a bit. So the moving average here in the Pro Indicators, which is the gray zigzag line, is exactly around 42,000. Also, the mid channel of the context, which is the blue line, is now above the moving average. So this is the one of the most important areas. If we retrace back to 42,000, this is the most important area, and I will put it on the screen so you guys can see it. Just below the mid context line and above the moving average. So this goes from, let me see if this is correct. Yeah, this is correct here. So let me see the coordinates. So this goes from 42,000 to 43,000. This is an important area if you really want to, of course, invest more heavily in Bitcoin. I would say that the most speculative and very interesting area right now is this one, if it happens that we go to the 42,000 level. If we don't, of course, you know that you have already the intermediate levels, which I will just show you on the next chart. So I will keep this in mind. This green area here is really, really a good speculative area if you want to go long on Bitcoin, of course. And this is defined by the conjunction here of the moving average of the Pro Indicators framework and the mid context line, which indicates the middle area between the gray boxes, the resistance context, sorry, the support context and the resistance context on the top. That's a very, very good area if we go there. And I'm looking at this green rectangle every day and trying to analyze what is happening on the charts to see if the probabilities of going to 42 are actually in play or not. So just very, very quickly, let's take a look at the dollar. The dollar has been going down for the past week, and the week is just starting right now with a new candle. But for now, there's no action. We went already a bit below the closing of the previous week, but now it just went back up again a bit. So it's kind of neutral for the start of the week, and we will have to watch it during the midweek, of course, to see how this has evolved. Really quickly, also on gold. Gold was able to surpass the trend line again. So we are above the white trend line, which was the trend line supporting the price for a long time. Then we had this very, very quick retracement and going back up again. Then gold was able to break above the trend line and is now being supported again on this new candle, which just started this week. I don't see gold going much lower than this if the support of the moving averages and the trend line in conjunction work together. Probably gold will be supported here and have a continuation to the upside, but I would say 60-40 probabilities that we continue to the upside, because the bears are really strong here, and we also have to surpass the yellow line, which is this 50 period SMA. So let's see how gold evolves. I just don't believe that we are going much lower than that, and probably the trend line will support the price action. And now to close the video, of course, just the bigger outlook of Bitcoin. Let's see how this looks. We, of course, lost the trend line here, the trend line of the bull's control, and the MACD is going a bit to the lower part of the chart. But in any case, I've plotted the levels that I really consider important. I still believe that this move up is part of the fifth wave of the Elliott count that comes from since the bear market 2 years ago or more. I can give you guys the bigger outlook here. Let's put this in auto so we can see the entire chart. So this Elliott wave count started around the $3,000 level around December 2018. And I still believe that we are now starting the fifth and final wave of this Elliott wave count here to the upper side. So let's see. Of course, the fifth wave is composed by smaller waves, and we might be right now experiencing the final part of wave one of that wave five. So let's see how that goes. But let me go again here and zoom in a bit. So this is the bigger outlook of Bitcoin for now. We still have the white trend line here. The red trend line of life is really important. We cannot break it to the downside. And you guys already see that it will be very, very hard to break the red line again, because we will be, in any case, supported by the 42,000 level here, which has been support since January, since the first retracement of this bull run that happened in the first week of January when we started to go down here. So this was resistance and this was support several times all over this year. And the intermediate levels here in white, the 46 to 46 and a half thousand dollars level, which already supported the price once here and again here, and the $44,000 resistance, in this case support line, which already supported the price here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 times. So the $44,000 line since January this year has already supported the price 5 times. And then we have the big one here. So this is the outlook of Bitcoin for the beginning of the week. I hope you enjoyed, of course, this analysis of today. So guys, this was the update I had for you today. Just the start of the week. Nothing really, really important for now. We still have to see the complete outlook of this week, how this is going to evolve, if the retracement will continue, or if of one of those support levels will, of course, hold the price and trigger a price action reversal to the upside. But for now, this is what I have for you guys. This is the update of today. And the next video, of course, on Wednesday, we'll continue this update and see how we evolved for these 2 days. But for now, I will leave you guys with the wise words, of course.
All right, let's roll. Hey, let's be careful out there.
Let's be careful out there, guys. Gently touch the like button if you enjoyed this content. Subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends. Don't forget the notification bell if you want to be notified when I upload a video or have a live stream. But let's roll, guys. Be really careful out there in the markets, and I will see you again in the next one. Bye-bye.